I read a while back that the Bible uses the phrase, be not afraid, or fear not, over 365 times. That's one time every day. Hi, this is Tony Agnese. While I haven't been able to verify that fact, it's one of the most used phrases in the Bible. You know, fear is the one emotion that keeps us from trying new things, keeps us from achieving our goals, taking first steps. The status quo is comfortable. We fear change. We don't have to think or plan. We become paralyzed. And our inactions breed fear and doubt. You know, there's an old adage that the only people that like change are wet babies. And it's true. Most people would rather stay right where they are in a comfortable rut, fearful that they might make a mistake. We want to return to college, but we fear it'll take too long to finish. We want to get a new job, but we just can't get started on updating our resume. We want to meet new people, find new friends, maybe even someone that we can spend the rest of our lives with, but we're too afraid to sign up on a dating site. The same holds true with our faith, you know. We want to be better Christians. We want to be better Catholics. We want to do more, pray more, get involved in activities, work with ministries, but we fear taking that very first step. The problem is that thinking that time will pass either way, time's going to go by whether you get started or not. The hardest thing to do is to take that first step, but what are we afraid of? We have God's word that he's with us. He's our refuge, our strength, and our salvation. Shouldn't that be enough to get started? Here are a few things we can do to get the ball rolling. First of all, take some baby steps. Sit down, write down all the things you want to do. Break it down into small steps, small chunks, and take the first one right away. Have you ever heard that old saying, how do you eat an elephant? Simple, one spoonful at a time. Do you want to improve your prayer life? Then add a morning offering. Do you want to get a new job? Then dust off that resume and get started. Number two, be moving in the direction of your goals. As you begin, make sure that you're always moving in a positive direction. Don't get into that two steps forward, one step back trap. Complete one baby step and move on to the next. And finally, ask yourself this question. What have I got to lose? Remember, time's going to pass by whether you take action or not. But what will it cost you if you do nothing? Come on, you can do it. You've got God on your side. Why not get up and do it right now? If you enjoy watching these messages, we post a new one each week. The easiest way to find out is to hit the subscribe button above and subscribe. We'll send you an email when a new one is posted. That's it for today. Thank you for being with us. God bless you. This is Tony Agnese.